It looks like the Ghostbusters are gonna be getting a whole lot more calls. That's right. The new movie's post-credit scene has one heck of a setup for the franchise going forward, and I'm about to break that down. But first, a huge thanks to Sony's Ghostbusters Afterlife for sponsoring this video. Yes, we're getting a whole lot more Ghostbusters, and you could be one of them. Ghostbusters Afterlife Scare is a new augmented reality mobile video game which just came out right along with the movie. And you can download it on your phone right now by clicking the link below in the video description. The first two episodes are totally free to play, and I've played them. Sony gave me the game in advance, and let me just say, true story, I had so much fun with the first two episodes. It takes about 15 minutes to play the first two episodes. So I did the first two episodes, and I actually purchased the first full season pack. I think it was like $5. I mean, look, one of those is a mini Stay Puffs episode. I can't wait to do that one. I did the first two episodes by myself, just on my regular phone. I had an absolute blast. So cool. But I'm going to the reason I did purchase right away for the rest of the season was that I think this is going to be a great thing to do after my family goes to see Ghostbusters Afterlife. It totally extends the experience of the movie because it has actors from the film in there as well as some really great graphics. And look, Muncher! But, hey, we have Thanksgiving weekend coming up, right? So you got all this time with your relatives. Why not turn to them and say, hey, let's do some Ghostbusting, which is totally what it feels like to play this game. It's so great. So again, the link for Ghostbusters Afterlife Scare is down below, and it's available to download right now. Go get it. It's really fun, and the first two episodes are free to play to see how you like it. Have fun, and thanks again to Sony's Ghostbusters Afterlife for sponsoring this video. Now let's talk about that post-credits scene, which was so great. So yeah. We're getting more Ghostbusters. Ghostbusters Afterlife actually has two end credit scenes. The first is a fun callback to Peter Venkman's ESP test, only this time Sigourney Weaver's Dana Barrett is testing him. That was cute to see. But the second post-credit scene is what gives new life to Ghostbusters going forward. So you see, what happens is that Winston Zeddemore has become an incredibly successful businessman with a really nice office. And we find out that he's purchased the old fire station. He's got Ecto-1 in there, and a red light goes off as he's surveying, you know, what he's, you know, he's setting it back up. He's getting the business back together, and they're back in business, baby. So I thought that was so much fun. But this is just such a great launching point for the franchise from where to go from here. Because one of my favorite lines within the film is when Peter Venkman introduces himself to the kids and he half jokingly says, we're from the home office. I think he says like, we're from the home. My audience was going so crazy that I didn't hear all the lines totally the first, I'm gonna see it again. But I didn't hear all the lines totally the first time I saw it at New York Comic Con. But he's like, we're from the home office and we're like, we really like what you're doing here. It was great. But I love the idea of a home office for the Ghostbusters, right? Because it was very fun in the movie towards the end to see Ecto-1 driving across the bridge into New York City at night, siren blaring, just like in the first movie. But Ghostbusters Afterlife not only sells the idea that anyone can be a Ghostbuster, but that a Ghostbuster can be anywhere. See, Ghostbusters and Sigourney Weaver, interestingly enough, were part of a 70s, 80s trend of taking these big science fiction ideas and boiling them down to a point where they became extremely relatable, that the audience felt like that you could participate and made it something that could fit into your headspace, right? So like, for instance, Alien was truckers in space. Really clever idea. And then Ghostbusters took fighting the paranormal and turned it into an exterminator job. You can even see that reflected in the cost, you know, in the suits. That's brilliant. And since the Ghostbusters ran their organization like a business from day one, which was such a fun part of the movie, it makes perfect sense that they'd have chapters not just across the country, but maybe across the globe. Wow! So that means that in another movie or streaming show, we can explore all sorts of Ghostbusters, again, all over the globe. There are obviously great ghost stories in every country, so you could really tap into that. And you could have team-ups! Like, why focus on one country? Why not do a Ghostbusters business retreat, company retreat, or a conference, right? It could be either at the original New York City fire station or another state or country. I mean, the possibilities suddenly become endless with this idea, while still fitting in perfectly with the core idea of Ghostbusters, which is relatability and accessibility. Ernie Hudson will definitely be sticking around as he's now the boss. He owns the whole thing. And Annie Potts is featured in the end credit sequence as well, so I would assume she would stick around too. Dan Aykroyd is always up for more Ghostbusters, so that should be easy. And as for Bill Murray, well, he returned here and in 2016, so he's clearly open to the idea. So after watching Ghostbusters Afterlife and the end credit scenes, the post-credit scenes, is your faith restored in the future of Ghostbusters? Mine sure is. And what do you want to see for the Ghostbusters going forward? Do you like the idea of multiple teams all over the world? I like my conference or retreat idea the best because it allows for the most new teams and the most variety in teams. But at the same time, you can have appearances from the original Ghostbusters as they'd be running the event and sharing their experiences. So, wow, as I said, explosion of ideas with this setup. Very, very strong. So share your thoughts down below, subscribe today, and of course, as always, you can check out some more videos right now.